Welcome back, everyone. On today's midweek episode, we are going to be building up Italeri's 20-foot container trailer sent over by Model Roundup. They have this in stock right now, and you can order it and have it in your happy little hands, usually within a week, anywhere in the United States. So let's take a look at everything in the box when you get yours. It is in 1/24th scale. When you want to order yours, you can either look it up by Tecnokar 20-foot container trailer on modelroundup.com, or just kit number 3887 from Italeri. And like it says on the box, 100% new trailer molds. So let's take a look at everything that'll be in there when you get yours. First up, a big tree of rubber tires. This is a 6-tire trailer. These are really soft, nice tread pattern to them. And on this side, I don't see any manufacturer's label. Oh, on this side, it says regroovable, radial tubeless, and gives a tire size. So no brand name, but looks very nice as a actual size marking and grooving. So clearly this side faces out. They are super soft and definitely, can you smell? Smells like rubber to me. So they are very nice tires. We'll be able to detail those. We'll sand them down a little bit. It has a large decal sheet. The white decals are the Klein logos and the number logos you see down the side of the trailer, and the category, the numbers like the weights on the back and stuff like that. Otherwise, we've got yellow. We've got numerous license plates. So it's going to look sweet as a container trailer. Even got some notices and warnings. Made with Core 10 steel. Tecnokar trailers. Gives you the height, 8 feet 6 inches. All that cool stuff right on there for you. The instruction manual is standard Italeri. It's well done. Quite clear. We can see how we're going to be building the frame rails. Got our airbags, our air suspension, got our air tanks on there. And then they just have you go forward, build the frame of the trailer. Just like building any other big rig, but since it's a more modern kit, and you will have a lot of parts left over. Check it out. This addendum lets you know we're not getting those wheels. We're just going to be using the wheels and inners from a parts tree, and all this extra stuff, fenders and equipment, will be extra parts for the parts box, which we'll go look at those parts right now. Those ones that I showed you on that addendum, molded in silver, and it is a really nice silver on those wheels. I'm not even sure I'm gonna have to paint those. I can just get right to weathering them. But you're gonna have all these fenders left over. You're gonna have all these small parts, these hubs. You're gonna have these front wheels left over. And those trailer wheels are really sharp. You'll get two trees just like that, molded in silver in yours. Molded in red is the Klein trailer. Of course, it is red in real life. This is a very bright red, so I will be painting mine. Got our doors with the rails, and these are very prominent. We can easily get a silver or chrome marker on those, or silver paint with a brush. That's how prominent those are. Got our hinges all built in. I don't know if it can be molded open yet. We're going to find our built open. We're going to find out. Much smaller parts like the latches for the doors, we can get painted up separately and then glue on later. Got the corrugated sides, so get out the decal solvent to get that large Klein logo. These containers end up all over the world, so you can build it with any country in mind. We've got all of our ribbed patterns on there for the trailer. This must be the front of the trailer. It interlocks. I've built these Italeri trailers before, and they go together very nice. Then we've got duplicate trees for our rear doors. Our latches, so again, you're going to have some spare parts maybe. Corrugated sides. It's corrugated on the inside as well if you build it with the doors open. And our front panels. And you can see we got the male and the female tabs to lock the sides together. This is going to be a very glue, using a lot of glue on this kit. We've got two more identical trees with our black fenders. Check out the disc brakes with calipers. More common in Europe. Got all of our small trailer parts, brace parts, half of our airbags, nice thick axle so it won't bend or warp after the years. Nice detail on everything. Mounting plates, bolt heads. Nicely done. We got attachment points there for chains and lines. Straps and everything. You get two of those trees. And the frame tree. Real nice and big on this one. I like that the suspension is molded into the frame. That means we're not going to have a trailer that sits with one side down and one up. We got our rear bumper there. We got more suspension components. I mean, technically, you would just have to build this trailer and decal it if you wanted. I'm going to paint mine. I'm going to paint everything. Maybe not those wheels, but everything else is going to get painted because I want to weather it up and detail it. We got more brakes on here. Everything looks great. Looks like a really nice kit. I always have fun with these Italeri kits. They tend to build quite well. So I'm going to get working on my Tecnokar 20-foot container trailer, and I'll be right back.
Thank you.
a couple hours of gluing and things go together very nicely. The trailer itself lines itself up, the trailer frame and the trailer itself, the cargo container line itself up, everything interlocks. It would be, you would almost have to try hard to get this to not square up and to get the trailer to not square up. You'd kind of have to try hard. Everything lines up well, as you saw during the assembly. Everything has a place, a hole or a slot. We got some holes we have to drill to add brackets and stuff that we just use a very small drill bit for. I used in that section a 1.15 millimeter drill bit, and it seemed to work out absolutely fine in my little pin vise. And this is where we are at this point. So we've got some small parts outside that we can get painted, and then we're going to do things as a larger assembly. We got the nice wheel set, and that is nice looking. I'll go over it and spray it and repaint it in a metallic tone, but they look very nice as is. And even on camera, they look metallic, but I like to use spray paint, so I'll be doing that. The handles, I definitely don't want to leave the handles for the trailer doors in a red plastic, so I'll be turning those into a metallic color. So I just left them on the tree and I can cut them off and super glue them into place towards the end. The wheel hubs that will go in the center, we'll leave those black. We'll attach those at the end of the build, or near the end at some point once we have the wheel and tire package on. The landing gear for the trailer jack, I'll just leave off to the side. I don't want to, they can stay black, and I don't want to paint them so that they still slide in and out and can be adjusted. Same as the handle for the jack. That's already black. There's no reason we'll detail that. Dry brush it a little bit. That will fit in just fine. The wheel chocks, I want to paint up and get more of a rubberish tone. So I will do that on my own, on their own little tree. The six fenders go on very nicely, and I'll show you that in just a second. But I did leave those off. I can hang on to their mounts. This one's got the mud flap. We can get these painted, we can get these detailed, and then glue them on with super glue at the very end of the build. So we've got our container here. You see how nicely it fits on the trailer. It is a nice tight fit with those mounts all the way around. You can see that it's all square. So now, and it is a nice tight fit. It'll be even tighter with the paint on it. We got that awesome container. You could mount the doors, I suppose, open, but there are no working hinges, so I did mine completely sealed, and now we have that nice container. We got, for the slides on the side, we got these little plastic brackets. Don't forget to add those. A good effect will be to press these in and dent them like they're banged around, but you can see how they can strap them and slide in the larger style forklifts to move these around. We got all of our mounting points so that they can stack them on a ship. We've got the front with the grooves for the trailer. We've got the rear with the solid area that'll go over the bumper, and then our latches up top and up bottom for the doors. We'll have to paint all this silver. We could even accent the hinges, even though they'd probably still be red. Little details are fun, but that squares itself up nicely. You can't see any seams. This doesn't have a seam at all. You're not going to be able to see that seam once I get paint where that glue is. Same in the front. The way that seam is designed on that large groove, we're not going to notice it when we get paint in there. And on the bottom, I mean, you can barely tell. If I didn't have glue on that, you wouldn't be able to really see where that went together. So that's a very nice container. Be cool for a diorama on its own too, like a dude living in it or storing a car in it or something like that. That'd be awesome. The chassis itself should be all black anyways, so I assembled the whole thing. I thought, well, why bother? I can get everything glued in solidly and then paint it, repaint it black to get rid of that glue look and then start weathering it and whatnot. Get rid of that shiny plastic, but that's a very nice looking unit. We got our landing gear here. We got a nice little storage box on the side. We got some equipment on the side. We've got our air tank in there. We've got the handle, the crank that goes between the landing gear. They even had us put that in. We've got our kingpin. We've got our mounts for the trailer edges. We got our tail lights in there. We got our rear mud flap. Of course, you could alter this for a more US trailer, but I built it out of the box for the review. And that looks great. It's got all the disc brakes all the way around. I really like how they have made it super easy with the air brake detail. It looks just as nice as all the other ones, but it's not such a fragile assembly that it's going to snap off when I get in here and start dry brushing and beating up the trailer like they all look. We got our trailer rails everything just squares itself up nicely, especially when you get the kingpin mount in the front. That's what I mounted first to get that squared off, and then we can just start putting it all together, and then we can put our container on the top, and it takes a second to line that up. But it does go in. I always line the back sides, then I squeeze those in, and there we go. And it's mounted up. So that is ready to go. I'm going to start working on everything in the paint booth, and I'll see you over there.
Thank you.
Another day, another fun build from the folks at Model Roundup, who sent over Italeri's kit number 3887, the Tecnokar 20-foot container trailer. I Americanized it as much as I could. I didn't do the taillights the exact same way they are in Europe. We still have the three-axle trailer. You could easily not install the third axle and just have a double axle in the back. You would not have to have that front axle, but since it was in the kit, I did use it. The container assembles super easy. You could pose that container with some open doors. They are not hinged. You could obviously hinge them from the inside, or you could pinch the hinges in the side mounts and mount those open with a car in there or some exotic machine that they were shipping over. I've beaten mine up because I have yet to see a new container in my entire life. Obviously, they are there. Like on the box art, they have to come from somewhere brand new. But in the Midwest, I've never seen one by the time it makes it out here from a few international trips where it is in anywhere near nice condition. The last thing I did with that darker paint, rubbing it in and rubbing it off, is the soot from the American side, from the exhaust of the diesel engines, blowing over the top depending on where it's being hauled all around the country. Right now, it must be in Europe. It's on a European base, but this container could end up anywhere in the world on any sort of a 20-foot trailer base and be worked out. It would make for a cool diorama with an exotic sports car or a muscle car being found in a field or something like that, and they stuck it in a 20-foot container and left it there for 20 years. I did like to wear out the decals, rough it up and all that. These things are always getting banged and bruised and beaten up on the road and in those container ships. And how many times has a new guy been using a crane and just smacked the bejesus out of these things? So I made sure to remove the paint on all the contact points and all of our common wear points on the sides where they will rub on equipment and stuff like that, and chains and other stuff like that. Paint the hooks on the trailer. We get our taillights done up and all that stuff, and then rusted the trailer out, but didn't corrode it completely, just surface rust over that black paint. The fenders themselves, I just scuffed up a little bit, and I did those two fenders in raw metal, figuring they ordered some replacement fenders, they put them on the trailer, they didn't have time to paint them up or make them look nice. They just took the raw metal that arrived and bolted it up and said, well, to heck with it, it's gonna rust anyway, so let's just stick it on there. The wheel and tire package looked great. I went with an aluminum style wheel, and I did not try to obviously rust those. The spray coat over the black gave me enough of a mild pitted or used texture to them, and I enjoyed that quite a bit. I enjoyed the entire build quite a bit. I got this all done in 2 days easily. Put the decals on, they conform beautifully, as you can see that, no bubbles, no nothing. They went down lovely. The trailer goes together easy. It even has hookups for airlines in the front. For you super detailers, you could run airlines to your brakes and everything. It's got all the necessary details. The trailer jack will lower up and down, though this trailer does stand just fine on its six wheels. But you could, like I said, you don't have to install that front axle. You could leave that off. As you saw, those parts went on in the assembly area, and you could build it that way. So I thoroughly enjoyed this. It snaps on and off the trailer easily. Pull it off. You can see that nice trailer with some rust on it and some minor details, just enough to look used, and I really enjoyed myself. Thanks to Model Roundup, they've got this kit in stock right now. So either search their website for container trailer Italeri, or just that kit number should pull it up for you. This is The Workshop. I'm Chris, and I'll see all of you at the next review.